So in the previous video, we were discussing about the IP datagram, and we are discussing the second row now, which is about the fragmentation. Now let me do one thing. You must be having a diagram in front of your screen. Draw this diagram on your notebook, and also draw these tables on your notebook, because I feel that once you are going to draw this, then only I'll be able to make you understand each and everything more clearly. Draw both of these things in one single page. Pause the video and draw. So I feel this screen might not be very clear to you. That is why I ask you to draw this information. Okay. Now here you can see this table. Now here you can see this table is representing an IP header. Okay. So if you see every table, it is having few parts. For example, here this is the version field, and this is your header length field, then this is your type of service field or DF field, and this is your total length field of IP datagram. This is your identification field, this is your reserved field, this is your do not fragment field, this is about your more fragment field, and this is your offset field. So we'll discuss about each and every field one by one. So whenever you send some information or some data through the network, how the values in all these fields changes. Take some time and draw this diagram as well as draw this diagram. So I've taken these two diagrams from the frozen book. You can also open your book and you'll find exactly the same diagram. Or you can just visit the website. This is www.digimentor.com to download the PDF copy of this presentation, or you can say the PPT. Now, this is your original sender. So let us say the sender is sending some data packet whose size is around 4000 bytes. I mean to say, we had an application layer, we had a transport layer, we have a network layer, and then we have the data link layer, and then we have the physical layer. Now the message that we got through the network layer, that is around 4000 byte to the network layer. I mean, this network layer got a message from the above layers, which is around 4000 bytes. Now to these 4000 bytes, this network layer is going to add its own header. So this network layer is going to take this 4000 bytes of payload here, and it is going to add its own header. So let us assume this header is of 20 bytes. Therefore, the total length of this entire packet is now 4020 bytes. So this is the total length, and the header length is of 20 bytes. So if you see this in this particular case, what is the information that we stored in every field? So the very first field is your version information. So version is IPv4, so it is going to store 4. The second field is your header length field. Now because we are using a header which is of 20 bytes, therefore this header length field is going to store a value which is 5, because it is a multiple of 5. Okay. So this is your version, and this is your header length, which is multiplicable of 4. So header length is of 20 bytes. Now this is your type of service field. Right now we don't need this, and this is your total length field, and total length field is around 4020 bytes. So this is stored in the form of binary in 16 bits. I think you remember their sizes also. Now the very first field here is the identification field. Now this identification field, actually it is a 16 bit field. It is a 16 bit field, and this identification is actually a unique number that is given to every IP datagram. Every IP datagram will be having a unique number, which is called as an identification field. So because this identification is a unique number, and we use 16 bits, so it is just like we are storing a short integer in the program in your main memory, and that actually for this we use a short int. Now because short int is of 2 bytes, so this short int is containing the values between 0 to 2 raised to power 16 minus 1. So this ID field can contain any value between 0 to 2 raised to the power 16 minus 1. Okay. Now we give an ID to a datagram and then we'll increment this identification value by 1. So for example, every datagram that is going to come from the network layer, after every datagram we are going to increase the value of this identification field. Now currently do not worry about this do not fragment field. So but here we are worrying about the more fragment field. More fragment field, how many data grams, how many datagrams are currently coming? I mean, is there any other datagram or network layer packet that is coming after this packet? So because it is having the value 0, that means there is no other packet after this particular packet. So you see this diagram here, original message was generated here. This original message was of 40 bytes, so 4000 bytes. So with this 4000 byte, we added 20 bytes of header. And there is no other byte, there is no other datagram that we have generated. Therefore, more fragment field is going to be 0. More fragment field means, is there any other IP datagram that will come after this or not? If the no other IP datagram is coming after this, therefore more fragment field is going to be 0. Then we will give this to this data link layer. Now, data link layer will check the MTU of the network, that is maximum transmittable unit of the network. Now, for example purposes, let us say the MTU of the network is 1400 bytes. Therefore, these 4000 bytes needs to be broken down into packets of 1400 bytes. Okay, so we'll break down into 1400 bytes. The first packet, then second will be 1400 bytes, and third will also be of 1400. So third will be of 1200 bytes. And then we'll add a header with every small packet here. So this will become 1420 bytes. This will become 1420 bytes, and this will also become 1220 bytes. So this is the IP datagrams which are divided. So original 4000 byte packet was divided into 3 packets, and each of size 1420, 1420 and 1220. So I just demonstrated this with the help of this diagram. So this was the original packet. So because it is of 4000 bytes, 4000 byte means byte number 0 to byte number 3999. And with this 4000 byte, we are having 20 bytes of header. And this is the network layer, or you can say IP header. This is 20 bytes of IP header. And this is the 4000 byte of data that you got from the transport layer. So this 4020 bytes is there, the total size. This is the identification number, which is initially a random number, a random positive number between 0 to 2 to the power 16 minus 1. This is saying that there is no other packet that is that we are generating after this, and this is the offset. So offset is demonstrating how many packets are after this, I mean how many packets already crossed this. Okay, so I mean if you are having current packets, so how many packets are going before this particular packet, we'll see that. So we broken down this original message into 3 small fragments. And the size of the first fragment here, it is of 1400 bytes. The size of second fragment is also 1400 bytes. And the size of third fragment is of 1200 bytes. So if you add 1400 plus 1400 plus 1200, which is 4000 bytes, because the MTU of the network was like that only. Maybe 1500 bytes or something. So maybe, I mean, whatever the MTU is, according to the MTU only, we are going to break it. So if it is LAN, so maybe the MTU of the LAN is 1500 bytes. So we have taken each and every one of them and we have added a network layer header with them. So with this we have added a header, with this we have added a network layer header. Now the size of this packet will become 1420, the size of this packet will become 1420, the size of this packet will become 1420. So this header and this header, so header of all these frames are going to store of 1420 as the total length. So this is the total length field, the total length field, the total length field. So total length field of a frame. So you can clearly see here that one original message was broken down into 3 messages, and the length of every message is around 1420, 1420 and 1220 bytes. Now because the original identification number was 14567, So when you have broken this message into smaller fragments, so this identification number will not change. So identification number for every fragment is going to be same. It means that whatever the data packet that you have created, so whatever the data packet you have created initially, that was a 4000 bytes. Now we have created an identification number for those 4000 bytes. And then when we sent the data packet through the network, so in the network, because the MTU of the network, because the MTU of the network was smaller, maybe it is of 1500 bytes. So we had to divide this original message into smaller fragments. But the identification number will not change. Why? Because at the receiver's end, when the receiver will get all these fragments, the receiver should know that all these fragments actually belonged to exactly the same message or the same IP datagram, so that we can apply some assembly algorithm on the receiver's end. So receiver will apply some assembly algorithm to combine these messages according to their order. Okay, so this value will not change. This value will again, it will remain same in all these three fragments. Okay, so the fragments are fragment number 1, fragment number 2 and fragment number 3. So this is representing the fragment number 1, this is representing the fragment number 2 and this is representing the fragment number 3. So let me clear it again. So this is representing the fragment number 1, it is fragment number 2 and it is fragment number 3. So here we have this field which is the more fragment field. So if you see this fragment, is there any other packets that is coming after this? Yes, there are packets that is coming after this. Therefore, here this more fragment field is 1. Is there any other packet that is coming after fragment number 2? Yes, there is more fragment field is 1. Is there any other packet that is coming after fragment number 3? No, that is why the more fragment field is 0. Okay. And then we have the fragment offset. So fragment offset is actually demonstrating how many bytes are going ahead of this. How many bytes are going ahead of a packet or of a frame. So this is actually frame. So how many bytes are going ahead of this frame? So that is demonstrated by offset. Now this offset field is of 13 bits and you can see the total size field here, it is of 16 bits. So you can see at maximum we can have maximum size that is going that might be going before this particular packet is represented by 16 bits, which is 65,535 bytes. So we have to make this offset field as a multiple of 8, just like this header length field is a multiple of 4. In the same way, this offset field is a multiple of 8. Now for example, let me just show it to you with an example here. Okay, so if you take this fragment or this frame, how many bytes are going ahead of this? So this is 1400 bytes are going ahead of this, 1400 bytes. Okay, so I think it should be 1420. So there are 1420 bytes are going ahead of this, where 20 bytes is a header. So if you divide this 1400 bytes by 8, so you'll see, so 8 you can divide by 1, so this remainder is going to be 6 and then it will be 60. So 8 into 7 is 56, so remainder is going to be 40. So here you are going to have 5, so 175. Therefore you can see there, because there are 1400 bytes are going ahead of this, 1400 bytes of the same data packet is 1400 bytes of the same data packets are going ahead of this. Therefore the offset of this will be 1400 divided by 8, which is going to be 175. So here it is going to store 175. Okay, and then if you see the fragment number 3, for the fragment number 3, how many bytes are going ahead of fragment number 3? So that is 1400 bytes in fragment number 2 and 1400 bytes in fragment number 1. So in total it is going to be 2800 bytes. So in this offset field of fragment number 3, it is going to be 2800 bytes divided by 8, that is going to be 350 350. That is why here the offset value is 350, here the offset value is 175, and here the offset value is 0. Because 0 means there is no byte going before this or ahead of this particular frame. Now, what happened here is, we have divided the original message into 3 frames. Out of these 3 frames, frame number 1 and frame number 2 are going through this path, because it is a connectionless protocol. IP is a connectionless protocol, and frame number 2 actually took a different path, and the MTU of this path is different. So maybe the MTU of this path is less. MTU of this path is less according to the size of this particular frame. So again, this router is again going to fragment, the given frame into smaller frames, so that we can transmit this frame number 2 to this particular path. Now, so if you divide this into two frames, so let us assume the first frame size, the size of the first frame is 800 bytes, and the size of the second frame is going to be 600 bytes. So total 800 plus 600 is 1400 bytes. So it was frame number 2 was of 1400. So we have divided the frame number 2 through this part as 800 byte and 600 byte. So with these 800 byte, I'm going to add again 20 bytes of header. With these 600 byte, I'm going to add 20 bytes of header. The size is going to be 820 and 620. So the size 820 and 620. And again, the identification number will not change. Identification number, because these are all the fragments of exactly the same IP datagram. Because these are the fragments of exactly the same IP datagram, therefore, for every fragment which came from the same IP datagram, the identification number will be exactly the same. Identification number will not change. It will not change. Okay. Now, look at this field. So it is 1, so that means more fragments are following this. We know that after fragment number 2, then fragment number 3 is also there. That is why the more fragment field here is 1. Now look at the offset. Look at the offset. Offset here is 175 and offset here is 275. Because before this fragment number 2.1, there's only one fragment ahead of this. So you can see we have fragment number 1, now we have fragment number 2.1, now we have fragment number 2.2, then we have fragment number 3. So fragment number 1 is of 1400 bytes, fragment number 2 is of 800 bytes, fragment number 3, 2.2 is of 600 bytes, and fragment number 3 is of 1400 bytes. So what is the value of offset for fragment number 2.1? So value will be 1400 divided by 8, that is going to be 175. What is the value of the fragment offset for this fragment number 2.2? So how many bytes are going ahead of this? That is 1400 plus 800, which is 2200 bytes are ahead of this. So 2200 divided by 8, which is going to be 275. That is why this value of offset is 275. So you can see in the fragment number 2.2, the value of offset is 275. So this way, this entire second row is actually taking care of the fragmentation. Now, I feel this might be a little difficult. I feel this might be a little tricky. Do one thing, just revise the video, watch it again and again until you do not understand this. Because this is one of the very important concepts for your GATE examination. There are sometimes they are going to ask questions based on this, and these questions might be tricky if you do not know any of these fields and how these fields are working. So let us just read out some theory about this. You can rewind the video and watch it over and over again and again unless you understand the concept. So do not go forward unless you understand the concept till this point of time. Now look at this one. So we have the fragmentation. So fragmentation is the value of MTU differs from one network to another network. For example, LAN, the fragmentation is 1500 byte, but in case of WAN, sometimes it can be very huge, sometimes it can be very small. So if you divide a datagram into smaller fragments or in smaller frames, so that is process is called as fragmentation. Now this fragmented datagram is then going to be reassembled at the user's end, who is going to read the entire datagram. So when the datagram is fragmented, each fragment has its own header. the fragmented datagram may itself be fragmented, it encounters the network through an even smaller MTU. For example, you can see here the fragments, the original message was fragmented into three messages, and again because fragment number 2 chosen a different path, that is why fragment number 2 is again divided into two different fragments. So a fragment can again be divided into fragments. But you can see here it is not going to be combined. These fragments are not going to be combined at the router. These fragments can only be combined at the receiver. Even the MTU of this path can be higher than the MTU of this path. But still, even if the MTU is higher, in the path, routers are not going to combine the fragments. They are not going to assemble the fragments, but rather only the receiver is going to reassemble the fragments. So receiver is going to take all these fragments and the receiver is going to combine these fragments to make one single IP datagram. Now you can see these fragments can receive out of order. Therefore, at the receiver's end, we have to apply searching and sorting algorithms to sort these fragments. So you can see in every router, because they are having network layer, so they should implement or they have to implement searching and sorting algorithm for these fragments. I think it might not be necessary for the routers, because routers do not have to reassemble them, but only the host have to reassemble them to which you have to send the message. So the host or the receiver should have the capability of apply searching and sorting. I think the routers do not need to apply searching and sorting algorithm because they do not require this. Okay, so these are the fields. The first field is the identification. So we need identification source IP to uniquely define a datagram. Then when a datagram is fragmented, the identification field is copied to all the fragments. As you can see here, this value is copied to all the fragments, and then the identification number helps the destination to reassemble the datagram. So when the destination is going to get the datagram, it will reassemble them according, if they have the same identification number, then all those packets will be reassembled. And then it knows that all fragments having the same identification value should be reassembled into one datagram. Now we had three bits here, which are the flag bits, which is the leftmost bit, which is reserved, we do not use it. The second bit is do not fragment field, we'll discuss this in later point of this video. And the third field is the more fragment field, we discuss this more fragment field in this video. We already discussed this, that is there any other packet that is coming after this particular packet. Do not fragment means when you do not want a router to fragment a packet, when you do not want a packet to be fragmented by the router, then you are going to set the do not fragment field as one. For that, we need to understand what is the ICMP packet. So what is the responsibilities of ICMP packet? So we'll discuss that later part of time. But for now, just need to understand that do not fragment means you are not going to allow the router to fragment the packet, but rather only the sender can fragment the packet. Now, we know what is the fragment offset. Again, I told you it is a 13-bit field which tells how many bytes are going ahead of this particular fragment. So this is the introduction regarding the fragmentation, that is the second layer of this IP datagram. So we have just discussed the entire second layer. Now let us go through the third layer, which is third row, which is the time to leave protocol and header checksum, so that we'll discuss each and every field one by one. And then we'll conclude the total lectures of IP datagram. I hope that you enjoyed this lecture. Let's move on to the next lecture.